Note, the following video depicts a specific configuration of the notebook. The same removal and replacement procedures apply to all configurations of the notebook. Before you begin, remove the bottom cover, battery, optical drive or optical drive dummy, hard disk drive assembly or solid state drive, wireless WAN module, wireless LAN module, modem module, top cover, and system board. Removal. Important. Make careful note of the routing of the display panel and wireless antenna cables for later replacement. With the notebook resting on the display panel assembly, remove the wireless antenna cables from the routing channel on the bottom of the base enclosure. On the top of the base enclosure, guide the wireless antenna cables through the cutout in the base enclosure and remove them from the routing channel. Guide the display panel cable through the cutout in the base enclosure and remove it from the routing channel. Important. Make careful note of the placement of the foam pad on the left display panel hinge for later replacement. Remove the foam pad that is attached to the left display panel hinge. While supporting the display panel assembly, remove the 4 6mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the display panel assembly to the base enclosure. Lift the display panel hinges off of the alignment pins on the base enclosure and remove the display panel assembly. Replacement. Note, before installing a new base enclosure, remove the following from the old base enclosure and install on the new base enclosure. Audio board, RS232 connector cable, RJ11 connector cable. Place the display panel hinges onto the alignment pins on the base enclosure. Replace the 4 6mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the display panel assembly to the base enclosure. Place the foam pad into position on the left display panel hinge. Route the wireless antenna cables through the routing channel on the top of the base enclosure and guide them through the cutout in the base enclosure. Route the display panel cable through the routing channel on the top of the base enclosure and guide it through the cutout in the base enclosure. On the bottom of the base enclosure, route the wireless antenna cables through the routing channel.